So we just saw White Bird, I think that's the title.
Yes.
It was a mystery movie here at the Regal. So you come and you're going to show a movie that's coming out in the upcoming weeks early. And so you don't know what you're going to get. So I didn't know what I was going to get. And as the movie starts unfolding, I'm thinking about, I should go home and watch something else. I should curate my whole thing. And I'm happy I did it. This movie was incredibly moving. It's a movie about kindness and love and courage. And over and over again, the people in it have to display that. The second half of the movie, I felt like someone was sitting on my chest. That's how moved I was. The Nazis are, obviously it's horrible, but you have these two young actors who you couldn't ask for any more. They just were extraordinary. Yeah, one of the things that's in English and, it would have been in French, but one of the eats of the story is that Helen Mirren's character is telling the story to her grandson. So you can go, so she's talking in English to her grandson. This could be in English as well. Very layered, very literary. There's symbolism, there's uh-ohs, there's oh shits, there's heartbreak, and there's some, convenient things that happen in the story. There's one CG scene which I didn't particularly enjoy, but I'd struggle with, the production of the movie versus the emotional part of the movie, and what are some things I change here and there, and that's how I sort of come to my score. But for this, I want the love that these two kids had, I want the courage that the youngest kid displayed, I want more people in the world like these people. So it's get moved just thinking about it. But so this movie brings this. So it's what do you do? I mean, it was constructed, and it's based on a book, and I bet the book is amazing. But I thought it was well adapted too. Not every book is well adapted. I think they kept the parts they needed. They probably could have cut a little more, but it was, beautiful. I'm gonna give it an 85, just because I needed this catharsis, and it also talks about catharsis in this, through movies and art and everything, so. And my story, my brother and I, our story is similar. We're Cuban, mom fled Cuba when she was 10, a communist dictator takes over and our parents flee and she has to be without, her parents, and so that sort of happened in this in a way. I mean, obviously we weren't the Nazis, but yeah, 85, so. I think if you saw the trailer and you were questioning it, I think there's nothing to question. I think that you should see it. I'm going to recommend it to a lot of my friends to see it. Thanks for watching my review. Please come be on a review. Come to the movies with me. I'd love to have you, and I love you, and I'm grateful that you watched my review. Peace and love.
We just saw White Bird, starring Helen Mirren, most prominently. A couple young actors that I don't really know well, but this was a very lovely romance story. Set in the world of the movie Wonder, if you ever saw that, there's a character from that movie in this, but it is not a sequel, it is a story set in that world, so worth noting. But ultimately, this is a completely different story. And I thought this was a very engaging love story. It really worked for me. It's largely set during World War II, which is an interesting standpoint. It gives you thoroughly loathsome villains to root against. The Nazis are all over this, and being as evil as you would expect them to be. All in all, I thought this was a very decently put together flick. It's not the best thing I've ever seen, but I got a genuine emotional reaction from it, and I was entertained by it, with some really good acting by Helen Mirren, the two leads, Ariella Glazer, and a blonde British kid whose name I don't remember. Gillian Anderson is in this and really wonderful in it too. N80. I thought it was really good. It's got some failings, but all in all, I really enjoyed it.